I'm here with the last video before Christmas for a little while. Little special thing for you, introducing some new teams and showing you a fun challenge. So you want to do is go into free battle. One player, obviously. I'm going to go with Waterfall Coliseum because Waterfall Coliseum's awesome. Now for this battle, you need level 50 Pokemon levels, level 50 all, and the number of entry Pokemon have no restriction. Alright, make it a double battle because that's just better. Right, the first of the two new teams. Alright, and then for your opponent, pick a rental pass. So there you have it for this one. So what we do here is, okay, here's one new team. Gengar, Floatzel, Yanmega, Absol, Leafeon, and Dialga. Right, so for this one, what you do, pick two Pokemon. I'm gonna go with Spook and Abs. Confirm that, so you have two Pokemon against all six rentals. Because putting no restriction on means the rentals will automatically go for a full house. You know the good thing about this Gengar? I got it without a Ghastly, or Haunter, or trading, or cheating. Because you can catch them in the wild. Yeah. Right, so we've got the Sludge Bomb on Grottle. I had Sludge Bomb, that's exactly why I had Sludge Bomb. Right, and Swordist Dance for Absol.
And now, the battle begins. Spy, by Sludge Bomb.
Shot. Gengar's awesome.
Taking out already.
Just one thing I want to talk about while I show you the battle here. Disconnectors. Because, I mean, I think I've faced a couple of people disconnecting before. Not Wally, but I did have a disconnection problem with Wally World, but we know that that wasn't Wally World's fault. That was technical difficulties.
What kind of developments can we expect to see next?
Alright. Either way. Oh, whoops. Wrong one. Damn. Alright, anyway. Yeah, disconnections. See, people who disconnect, it's just incredibly unsportsmanlike. And doesn't show you don't respect your opponent. Or you're not confident in yourself and enough to lose.
It
shows a lack of confidence in yourself. So you mean you never know. Pokemon, there is a lot of Pokemon is luck. You never know what could happen. Right, so I'm gonna try and get goodbye. And we're on Night Slash Print Club.
A fierce blow! Such amazing power!
This team isn't properly EV trained, I just went nuts with the medicines. So they have a very even spread of EVs.
Big hit.
Ooh, a crit! Swords Dance! Ooh! That's not nice, you really don't want to be in the receiving end of that. Absol's attack is just beastly. I think it's 120 or 130 or something like that. But then its speed is only 70, so that's why it's not so good.
What kind of developments can we
Dark Pulse Gallant. And we'll Night Slash Luxio. Dark Pulse looks so cool. Visually, I mean, it's awesome. How many more we got left? Ooh, more crits. How? That's gotta hurt.
Staravia is sent out.
No, Staravia's going down. Alright, so Absol is now plus one instead of plus two. That doesn't matter because Thunderbolt's going to knock this thing straight out. If it doesn't, then we got a problem. But oh well. Another Night Slash.
Gengar starts to attack. By Thunderbolt.
Yeah, Staravia's down.
A huge amount of damage is down. The battle has ended. It's a total victory for the blue corner.
Right, so now to show off the second one. I'm in the first one. This type of battle is a really good challenge for you. You set up two of yours against rentals. A team of six rentals. So this the air waterfall coliseum again, I love that. Rule one, which is my no limits. Now for the second one, this team is properly EV trained. I made sure of that. Same rental pass again. Right, and this time we'll go with my Salamence and my Sharpedo. Yeah. Five physical attackers and a special attacker on this team. Special attackers, Salamence. They all have a similar EV spread. 50 EVs in HP, defense and special defense. And then 180, all of them have 180 EVs in speed. And then 180 in their attacking stat. Okay, so we got some intimidation on this side. And some intimidation on this side. But that doesn't matter for Salamence, because Salamence is a special attacker.
The relaxing waterfall seems to be
nice moveset there. We'll go with the Dragon Pulse on Plurin and Flup. And then Ice Fang on Staravia.
The battle begins! The blue corner makes the first attack! A rigid shot!
Now, what's Plurin Flup's special defense like?
A fierce blow! Staravia!
I would have had that if it weren't for that special attack drop. I mean that attack drop. Could that end it? Yes! Haha!
Unbelievable! The Pokemon that just used the move went down!
That is pretty nice.
Goes to show you, you never know what will happen at a Pokemon.
Now that is a very stupid move. Because now Aqua Jet's powered up. And Hydro Pump's powered up. So, props to me.
The bite is sent out. The red corner has already
right,
taken
Dragon Pulse couldn't flop again, because that'll finish it.
Of a
and then another Ice Fang for goodbye. Quadruple. My Salamence is just deadly.
By Dragon Pulse. It went down.
Honestly, I just thought, I looked up for what moves Salamence can learn, found this moveset, thought, yes, that's a good moveset. Then I looked on, I got bored, so I looked on Serebii, and they have a Pokemon of the Week thing. Where they show off movesets and your Salamence, and I managed to pick what I managed to pick their special attacking moveset. So you know that's pretty cool. I might swap its item though. I'm gonna give it a wise glasses or something like that. Maybe choice specs, I don't know. I'm not a big fan of the choice items. They effectively force you to switch.
It's pouring rain in the Colosseum. I wonder how this is going to affect the battle.
Heat wave and Aqua Jet. Let's go for that.
A fierce blow, Monferno!
That is powerful. That's good stuff.
Burned by Heatwave. It couldn't survive the second hit and goes down.
Okay, so Monferno's out. That could be painful. That's alright, Sharpedo's down. I'm now with one Pokemon. Thank God for Rough Skin at least.
It went down!
Okay, all down to Salamence now. I can do it. Salamence is awesome. Oh, perfect. Right, he's got two Pokemon left. And whoever survives this is getting a hit, getting a Draco Meteor to the face. I don't care. Russell should go down. Okay, Grottle didn't go down. Spark will be normal.
A rigid shot.
Razor Leaf will do barely anything.
Solid hit, but this is not a favorable matchup. Well, both corners still have
another heat wave. Come on.
What kind of developments can we expect to see?
Come on, critical hit.
Burned by heat wave.
Alright, Grotal's nearly dead. Luxio is down. Come on. Oh, Grotal's burned, even better. barely anything again. Rains out. And Burn finishes it. Lovely.
It's all burned up now.
So it's my first proper EV trained team. It's tedious, but it is worth it in the end. EV training is absolutely the most tedious thing ever.
It's
a wonder I can actually do it. Alright, so that's two battles and a fun way to challenge yourself. Shadow X out.